When you're working with PowerPoint, usually your goal is to communicate information to someone or to a group of people. That information can be communicated in various ways, such as pictures or lists. Another way is by presenting information in an organized table. I want to tell people about the classes we offer at the High Tech Technology Center. I think a table will be the best way to present that information. There are several ways we can insert a table in PowerPoint. If the slide layout has a contents placeholder like this one, with the various insert commands, you can just click the Insert Table command. A small Insert Table dialog box appears. From here, you can choose how many columns and rows you want in your table. Let's see, I need 2 columns and 5 rows. Click OK and a table appears. Let's go ahead and enter some of our text. You can press the Tab key on your keyboard to move from cell to cell or use the arrow keys to navigate. I'll just skip the description right now and we'll enter that later. I have a few more classes to enter, such as Windows XP and QuickBooks. When we inserted the table, 2 new tabs appeared on the ribbon, the Design and Layout tab. Both of these tabs are table tools that appear when the table is selected. Did you notice how my table is a nice teal color that matches the slide? That isn't an accident. When you insert a table, it automatically appears formatted as a table style and color that looks good with our current theme, Concourse. We can see on the Design tab the table that is selected in the Table Styles group. In the Table Style Options group, you can see that Header Row is selected, which is why the table on our slide has a different color from the first row. Banded rows is also selected, which is why the table alternates colors for the rows. You can toggle any of these options on and off by simply clicking the box. If you want to select a different table style, just hover your mouse over a style in the group. A live preview of the style displays on the slide. We'll just click the More arrow to see all the options. I like the colors, but want something a little different. Just click a style to select it, and it will change on the slide. Next to the table styles in the same group, you can see 3 other commands that you can use to modify the table. The first one is the shading command. You can use this command to change the colors of your table. For example, if you want your header row to be a lighter color, just select the row. Click the shading command and choose a color from the menu. As you hover over a color, a live preview will appear on the slide. From this menu, you can also choose to use no fill color or even choose a picture from your computer to use to shade the selected row. You can apply a gradient to the existing color or a texture. I'll just stay with something simple and choose this slightly lighter shade. Sometimes simple is best. Using the border command, you can add a border to the entire table or specific rows, columns, or cells. For example, if I want to add a black line under the first row, I can just select the first row, click the Borders command, and choose Bottom Border. Now, when I click off the table, I can see a border on the bottom of that row. The third command is the Effects command. If you click the command, you'll see you have a variety of effects options, including beveling cells, adding shadows, and adding reflections. To use any of these options, just select the rows you want to modify, click the Effects command, and then click an option to select it. I think some of these cell bevel effects can be fun, but for right now, I'll just click Undo and stay with my current table. From the Design tab, you can also apply WordArt styles to text and change the table borderline width and color. The Layout tab offers you more commands that give you the ability to really modify your table. There are too many options to explain all of them, so let's go over the key points. Sometimes you may need to insert or delete rows or columns. For example, I realize I need to add a new class to my table. I want to add it beneath QuickBooks, so I'll just place my insertion points in that row and then click the Insert Below command to insert a row directly beneath it. You can also do the same and insert rows above a current row. To delete a row, just place the insertion points in the row you want to delete. Click the Delete command, and then select Delete Row. You can do the same thing with columns. Just place the insertion points in a column near to where you want the new column to appear. I want to add a column here, and so I'll click the Insert Right command. See, that wasn't difficult at all. Just so you know, if you don't want to use the ribbon commands, you can also right-click to display a menu with various insert and delete options while your insertion point is in the table. Sometimes I find this way faster than using the commands, but it will be up to you to decide what works best for you. Now we can see the first column changed a bit with the addition of the new column. If you want to adjust the column width or row height, just click the line and while holding the mouse button, drag it to the desired location. From the Layouts tab, you can change the cell and table size to specific measurements by simply selecting the cells you want to modify and changing the numbers in the fields. My insertion point is in the first row, and if I increase the cell height in the cell size group, I can see it change in the table. One last group I want to point out on this tab is the Alignments group. This contains commands that format the alignment of text. You can left, right, and center align text in your table by clicking the commands, and you can change the horizontal alignment of the text by clicking the Align Top, Align Bottom, or Center Vertically command. There are a couple of other commands on the alignment group, but I'll let you explore those on your own. At the beginning of this lesson, I told you there were a couple of ways to insert a table on a slide. If the slide layout you are using doesn't have a content placeholder with the Insert Table command, you can always select the Insert tab on the ribbon and then click the Table command. From the menu, you can use the squares to select how many rows and columns your table will have, or you can select Insert Table to open the dialog box we saw before. You can also insert an Excel spreadsheet as a table. Right now, I'll just use the menu to select a table with 5 rows and 3 columns. Then I'll just left-click and the table will appear on the slide. I obviously don't want this to cover my current table, so I'll just move the new table. To do this, place the cursor over the edge of the table. When the cursor becomes a crosshair with 4 arrows, click and drag the table, and then release the button to drop the table in the new location. Moving and resizing tables is just like moving text boxes and pictures. I'm going to go ahead and add the data to my tables. Why don't you give all these new table tools a try?